Steven Souza Jr. is a hit with his new team. The rookie outfielder now launches home runs for the Tampa Bay Rays. An offseason trade put the 26-year-old in a long-awaited position.
The opportunity is irreplaceable. You play every single day in the big leagues, and it just doesn't happen. I mean, I've sat so many times in the end of my bed and said, why? You know, 3 years ago, I was out of the game, and now I'm here. It's a dream come true.
It arrived after a career-beginning nightmare. Steven just turned 18 when drafted by the Washington Nationals as a third-round pick in 2007.
Jumping right in out of high school, that can get to be pretty heady stuff, can it?
Yeah. It's something I don't think you're really ever ready for. I think you see a lot of kids out of college aren't even ready for it, but they're a little more ready than high school kids. So that pressure to prove yourself that you were worthy of where you were picked always was there. You're so focused on yourself that you don't see what's going on around you. I was so worried about succeeding on the field that I disregarded other relationships with people and coaches.
His lifestyle grew reckless during four struggling years in minor league single A. His progression stalled. That led Steven to seek a quick fix through a banned substance. He was caught and suspended 50 games. He returned stronger physically, but emotionally demanding, carrying himself like a big fish in a small pond.
If we were to talk to former teammates, how would they have described you?
Selfish, worried about himself, angry. I think anger was a lot. You know, I had a short fuse, and with that added to more loneliness. You know, I thought the tougher I was, the more people would respect me. You know, I got in a lot of arguments, got in fights with teammates and stuff, just trying to keep that pride of, this is where I was picked, this is where I belong, I'm this guy.
The potential was there, but the productivity wasn't. His hitting, power, speed, fielding, and arm strength branded him a five-tool prospect. Steven's minor league coaches pushed him.
I had a manager in 2011 who just kept me accountable for everything. And it was frustrating. I wanted to do what I wanted to do at all times. I needed to be held accountable for, which was my effort. And he said, get out of the cage. And I said, no. And he came down and we got face to face. He said, get your stuff, go in the stands and sit down. And I said, I'll do you one better and I'll go home. And I said, I'm done, I quit.
Turns out the five-tool skill set wasn't enough. As a young minor leaguer, Steven needed more, an additional tool, a chisel, to help reshape his character, attitude, and reputation.
I read all these self-help books, they didn't work. I read books about centering yourself and whatnot, they didn't help. It just drove me into the ground more and more, realizing that my own depravity, I'm not gonna be able to help myself.
Done with baseball, Steven and his misery grew. Back home in Seattle, he knew he needed to change. Friends spoke about steps toward hope and restoration.
When you're at the beach sometimes and you're in this tide and all of a sudden you're trying to scratch and claw to get back and you can fight upstream and it's gonna take you a long time, all you have to do is just get back on the sand and walk back. And all I had to do was just give it up and just get out, just stop everything and look to God who could save me, because God's infinite and he can save us from all those things.
Steven went to church where he embraced a rescuing message.
How can I help myself if I'm already broken? No, I know Jesus can save me, I know that. If he really is the Son of God, I'm going to put my faith in him and I'm going to declare that this is the way I'm going. I'm going to be baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, and then I'm going to turn and walk away from my sin. And it was tremendous.
His turnaround was dramatic. Steven made calls apologizing to his manager and organization officials. He returned to play in the minor leagues, slowly earning his teammates' trust while developing new personal disciplines.
You may know that Jesus died on the cross. You may know that he fed 5,000. You may know that he raised Lazarus from the dead. But do you really know Jesus? This is how my relationship needs to go. Consistently talking with him, praying, and reading the word, and saw the fruits of the Spirit start to take over. The sin no longer appealed to me because I wanted to please my Heavenly Father.
Steven's game improved. After three highly successful seasons, he was promoted to the major leagues at the end of 2014. The Rays saw enough to acquire Steven as their starting right fielder. In this early part of the 2015 season, he's mentioned among Rookie of the Year candidates.
An everyday guy that's a really great, skilled baseball player that isn't afraid to share the gospel and live the gospel out. So, you know, I couldn't be happier to be a teammate with him and learn and grow with him.
How does one walk in confidence in a profession that demands it? but you carry it out with humility.
Yeah, I had to come back and I had to apologize to everyone for all the things that I did. That's not common, especially in this game, because there's a lot of pride in this. You're competing against a guy across from you for one job. No matter what happens here, I'm here to support you and love you and encourage you as a brother, as a person, as someone who God created. That humility is so different than the culture of baseball that it stands out. And it's not because of me, but it's because of the love of Christ in me.
Steven Souza Jr., whose big swing at redemption has unleashed power, transforming the man that makes the player.
I'm in this game because of one reason, because God has brought me here. And whenever he's ready to take it away, I'll go where he takes me. And it's not your success that has been willed, but it's by God's will that you have had success.